Hello and welcome. My name is Anthony, and today we're going to learn how to solve this problem. It's called Smaller Strings, taken from Google Kickstart Round C 2021. So you're given a string consisting of lowercase characters from the first K letters of the alphabet. So you're going to be given a number K. Now you're supposed to find the number of palindrome strings with the same length, which are lexicographically smaller than the string you're given. And those palindromes should consist of lowercase letters from the first K characters of the English alphabet. We're going to understand this problem by taking an example. But for now, they've tried to describe what a palindrome is, the input format and the output format. They also give some examples right here. All right. Before we start, I want to mention that this problem has a prerequisite called binary exponentiation, but you don't need to know much about that for now. I'm going to include a link in the description of where you could go to learn more. So let's start with what exactly is a palindrome. A palindrome is a word that reads the same forward and backwards. So A is a palindrome. A single character like C is a palindrome. DA is a palindrome. But ABC isn't a palindrome, because when you write it backwards, they are not the same, right? So for the question, you're given a string, for example, BC. You're given K, for example, 3. So the K means you can use the first three characters of the alphabet. So you could use A, B, C for a solution. And to find palindromes that have the same size as the input string, and also are smaller than the input string. So AA is an example. This is a palindrome. And because A is smaller than B, this is a valid answer. Another one would be BB, a palindrome which is smaller than the input. Okay. What about CC? Well, this is indeed a palindrome, but this string is greater than this. Okay, so C is greater than B, so we can't include this. Our answer right here is equals to 2, and you could see that from the first test case that your answer is 2. All right, now to solve this question, we're going to make some observations. The first observation is that we only need to consider the first half of the input string. And why is that? So let's say you have a string of length 4. All right, and you're trying to decide what to put in the first spot. So let's say you put B. Now for the rest of your answer to be a palindrome, you must also put B at the last spot. Okay? So what about the second spot? We could choose C. For this to remain a palindrome, we must also put C right here. So as you can see, just the first half would determine your answer. Okay? Because once you fix the first half, the rest would be automatically determined for the string to remain a palindrome. So that's the first observation. The second observation is that for each character within the first half of the string we are given, we can actually compute the number of palindromes. So let's take a specific example. So I'm just going to write it down. So for each character within the first half, we can compute the result. So let's take an example. Okay, so this is the first half, and we just need to consider that. Now, let's start with the first character, D. So K is equal to 5, so we can choose between A, B, C, D, E. Now, considering the first character, D, all we need to know is how many characters are less than D. Then we can find all the palindromes that start with that character. All right? So let's take an example, A. So A is less than D. We know that if you're going to set the first character as A, then we can choose whatever we need for the second character. So we could choose 5 elements here. We could also choose 5 elements here. And of course, once you've set the first half, the rest will be fixed. All right? So what does that tell us? For the first character, we could choose A, B, C, characters that are less than D. All right? So we could choose 3 characters. We could choose 3. And once we've selected that, we could then select 5 characters for the next and 5. All right? So this is our answer. Just to give a specific example, if we set A as the first character, then we choose the highest value, E, and E. We could then complete the rest, E, E, A. This forms a valid palindrome that is less than the original string. So like I said, for each character, we can compute the result. So for the first character, we've already computed the answer is 3 times 5 times 5. For the second character, the answer is we start with how many characters are less than C, and that will be 2, A and B. And for the next one, we could choose whatever we want, so that's 5. Okay? And then finally, for the last character within half of the string, we have 4 characters less than E. So this is how we're going to compute the result. I'm going to come back to this. But the last observation is that once we've computed the result with the algorithm above, we need to decide to add 1 or not. So why is that? So let's take our example again. So previously we were considering only characters that are strictly less than the character at each position, all right? Now, what if the first half itself could form a palindrome. Well, in this case, the palindrome would be DCE, ECD. This is greater than this, so it could not. So in this case, we're not going to add one. But if you had a different example like DCD, EBA, okay? So in this case, the first half would form the palindrome DCD, DCD. And this is less than the original character. So this is going to form an extra palindrome. So we need to add one to the answer. So that's basically it. Let's apply this algorithm to a specific example and see how it goes. So let's take an example from, so we have A, B, C, D, D, and K is 5. All right. Now for the first character, there are zero characters less than A. So this is zero. Of course, remember we're considering the first half. Zero times five times five, which is equal to zero. For the second character, there's only one character less than B times five, which is equal to five. And then for the last one, we have two characters less than C. And this is two. So when you sum all this up, you're going to get seven. So this is your first step, step one. Step two, we decide if we're going to add one or not, all right? So A, B, C, D, D. When you form a palindrome with the first half, you're going to form A, B, C, B, A, all right? Since this is less than this, B is less than this, we're going to add one to the answer. So answer becomes 7 plus 1, which is 8. So let's check. So you can see, this is the first test case. This is the second test case, which we just solved, and the answer is 8. All right. Now, the time complexity is going to be big of n because in the first step, we need to consider at least half of the string to compute the answer. And n over 2 is the same thing as big of n. We remove the constant, so they're equivalent. Also, in step 2, we need to check if we're going to add one, and we might actually need to touch the entire string, checking if the character here is greater than the character here. So this is big of n time. The space is big of one space because we're not really keeping track of anything. I'm going to go through the code next. All right, so this is the solution code. First, we read the input, n and k, and the word, and then we're going to solve using those parameters. So let's look at the smaller string function. So we know that if n is 1, we could just return the characters less than n, and we could compute that by simply doing this, all right? So just to give you an example, if you have just D, of course, K is always going to be greater than the number, and K is 5. Then only valid palindromes are going to be A, B, C, which are simply the characters less than D. So that's for the first part. So now we compute the result, okay? Like I said, you consider half of the string. And for each character, we compute the number of characters less than the current character. And then we multiply it by k raised to the power the remaining number of available space within half of the string. And that's what this is trying to compute. All right. So for now, you could consider this function as a black box that when you give it a number, it's going to raise it. So if you give it a number base and an exponent you wish to raise it to, and the modulus, it's going to compute the answer for you. But if you wish to learn more, you could take a look at the link. I'm going to also add this to the description below. So once you've computed this step one, you can move on to the next step. So the next step, you're going to decide if you're going to add one or not, based on the fact that when we form a palindrome with the first half of the string, is it going to be less than the original string or not? And that's basically what we are doing right here. Once we are done, we can return the answer. So I've already submitted that particular solution, and it was a correct attempt. So that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you found the content helpful, kindly like and subscribe.